Alright, hello, and let's continue with Danganronpa. Why don't we take a little break from the trial? I'd like you all to come see something.
Wait! Just what do you think you're doing?
Don't worry. This'll make the whole trial more exciting. I'm sure that thought must please you.
More exciting, you say? I wonder what Kyoko's talking about.
Huh? It'll make things more exciting?
Sorry, I was messing with the audio real quick.
Well, all right then. I declare an official class trial recess.
Huh? For real?
Now then, what is it you want to show us? It better not be boring or I'll be very unhappy.
Oh, I have no doubt it'll meet your lofty expectations. So, shall we go?
So before I even knew what was happening, the class trial had been put on hold. We headed off with Kyoko in the lead. And where she took us was...
the girls' locker room?
We've already searched this place top to bottom! What are you trying to pull, Missy?
I'd like you to examine the victim's body one more time.
You want to check it again?
Be sure to examine the entire body very carefully. Take your time.
Examine her carefully? Like using our hands?
You're not allowed to touch her, if you mean. You have to stay at least 10 feet away from her.
No way!
It's probably best if I don't run my hands all over a girl's dead body.
You see, Taka can touch her because he doesn't want to, so it's probably okay if he doesn't.
It's not that I'm creeped out or anything, it's just based on religious grounds, you know?
Very well. I'll do it.
But you're a girl! You shouldn't have to touch a dead body. Just let one of the boys do it.
It's probably for the best that Sakura doesn't.
No, it's okay. I think Chihiro would rather have a girl examine her. So just leave this to me.
Sakura?
What is this? Some kind of secret girl-on-girl action? Is that what you two are about?
That's not it at all. Stop screwing around!
Okay, here I go. I'm sorry, Chihiro. Please excuse the intrusion.
Putting her hands together in a brief prayer, Sakura then began to quietly examine her body.
Be sure to check her entire body, and I believe we will solve this particular mystery.
Her entire body? I know you say that, but... What? This is... What is this...
What did you find, Sakura? What's wrong? Oh damn, Sakura's pissed.
What is it?
Not possible. It's not possible.
She's gonna turn Super Saiyan. Sakura's eyes were staring wildly at Chihiro's lifeless form. Her massive frame trembled.
This girl is...
Is what?
Is a boy!
Tan tan tan!
Ah, I see. So she was actually a he.
What?
It's okay, Fumi. It's not that bad.
You're joking, right?
I wouldn't joke about this.
Then it's really true?
Chihiro was a guy?
A very cute guy.
Oh, what? You guys didn't know? Heck, I knew that right off the bat! Chihiro Fujisaki was totally a guy!
Then... he was a cross-dresser? Oh, no, I'm really on fire! I wish I had killed him!
I'm not sure if it's a good thing or a bad thing that Jill accepts it so fast.
So that's what Kyoko wanted to show everyone, huh? Interesting. Yes, that certainly does make things much more exciting. Now let's ride this wave of excitement back to the courtroom and get back to the trial. Ahem. I do apologize for keeping you waiting. Now then, let's resume the class trial. We've all just learned of the shocking revelation that Chihiro was actually a boy. Let's pick up from there.
I wonder how this game is gonna handle it. Probably not very well, but yeah, Chihiro was a boy.
Yes, well.
I wonder what Chihiro
saw. I don't know his reason for hiding it, but the fact is, Chihiro was not a girl, but a boy.
To think that Chihiro was actually a guy. The thought had never even crossed my mind.
And because the victim was male, he would have had no problem gaining access to the boys' locker room.
Assuming his handbook did, in fact, list his gender as male, then yes, that would be true.
Of course his handbook said he was a boy. He dressed like a girl, but he was a boy through and through.
Okay, I guess Monokuma's a final word on that.
So then, there should be no issue with Makoto's initial assertion. The victim was killed in the boys' locker room, and was then later moved to the girls' locker room. And the killer could have easily used Sayaka or Junko's handbook to get into the girls' locker room.
So, Chihiro really was killed in the boys' locker room?
I still don't understand the motive for moving the body, but... yes, that does seem plausible.
Well, I must admit, I did find it rather odd. I knew he felt a little... off. There was a certain incongruity to his female body.
Yeah, right, Byakuya. You couldn't tell at all. You never once mentioned it.
This is a most titillating situation!
So now everything has been connected. All the mysteries have finally become clear.
Okay, well, connected or clear or whatever, we still think you're the killer, remember?
Nah, I don't think Byakuya's a killer at all. Like, he didn't know anything about Chihiro or... the crime scene, like, he has too many unknowns.
Very interesting. This has become very interesting indeed.
Ah, He's off in his own little world.
What about you, Makoto? After everything we've learned, do you still think Byakuya's the killer?
Nah, well, at least I...
Well, without a doubt, Byakuya's the one that made Chihiro's death look like Genocide Jack did it.
But I
think he might not actually be the killer after all.
What? But aren't you the one who accused him in the first place?
Well, yeah, but we have new information now that we didn't have before.
He just seems to be too easygoing about all this. Like he's enjoying us solving the mystery. The way he's acting, it makes it seem like it doesn't have anything to do with him.
Because it doesn't have anything to do with him at all.
And you think that might be because it doesn't have anything to do with him?
Plus, the evidence he left behind was a little too... how can I put it? Overt. He consciously chose to use the extension cord, knowing it could connect him to the murder. At least, that's how I see it. And Byakuya, when you found out the murder took place in the boys' locker room, it seemed to rattle you. And then again, when you found out Chihiro was actually a guy. If you really were the killer, that stuff wouldn't have had any effect on you.
So that's your thinking, huh? Well, it bothers me that you don't have more concrete reasons, but... it's fine. I guess I'll mark it as correct, for the time being.
What type of reasoning is Byakuya looking for here?
Mark it as... correct?
He's right. I am not the culprit.
Hold on, I'm looking at my cash. It's reading really weird. Alright.
I just happened to come across the corpse in the girl's locker room and decided to alter it.
Are you fucking with us right now?
No, I am not effing with you right now. I'm telling you the truth.
Why did you say effing? You can say fucking. It's okay, Byakuya.
Well, I find it very hard to believe.
Go ahead.
Or your mom,
find it very hard to believe. You're free to be executed along with the rest of us.
If you're really telling the truth, then why? Why do you do that to his body?
My reasons hardly matter right now. Uncovering the culprit is much more important, wouldn't you say? Now then, if it wasn't me, who was it?
Well, I don't think I can say for sure without talking about it a little more.
We're seriously gonna keep going? We're all good, aren't we? I thought it was clear Byakuya did it.
No, I'm with Makoto. If there's any doubt whatsoever, we need to explore every possibility. Because if we're wrong, we all die here.
That's true. Very well then. I'm with you too.
Damn straight. Count me in.
Do you not have a mind of your own?
Of course I do. What am I, an ant or something?
Anyway, let's discuss this all as a group one more time. We still have time to make our decision.
That's very true.
Our lives are all on the line.
Excellent. Then shall we resume our game of hide and seek?
But if Byakuya didn't do it, then who's the real killer? Who murdered Chihiro? There's one thing we can be for sure that we know about the killer. The killer...
I got it!
Since the crime scene was the boys' locker room, you would need a boys' handbook to get in. Since Leon's handbook is apparently broken, the killer would have to use their own. In other words, it had to have been a guy. But that's still not enough, I need to find some more clues.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, clues are one thing, but... did nobody get a look at the killer?
I'm sure if someone saw the killer, they would have said something by now.
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some point. Even that might be enough for now.
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new info.
Shoot!
Jeez, that wasn't it.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Player 9 is it. Jeez.
Shoot! Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
Well, clues did nobody get a-
I'm sure if someone saw the killer, they-
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some-
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new-
It's over. It's all over. You want to know who saw the victim? The killer. And only the killer.
No, that's wrong.
I believe someone else did see the victim before he was murdered. What do you think, Celeste?
Now that you mention it, yes. I did see him.
Huh? Really?
Oh, but I suppose only Makoto knows about this. The rest of you had no idea, did you? That is why you're all making such ugly noises.
Whatever! Just hurry up and tell us!
It was last night, right before nighttime. I saw Chihiro. In the dormitory warehouse. I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag.
Off topic, but I just love Celeste's hair here. Look how much of a standout it is. It's actually like a famous cosplayer or something.
And then, I assume, he headed off to exercise.
A track jacket and a duffel bag? But we didn't find anything like that at the murder scene.
It seems likely that the culprit destroyed them to get rid of any evidence.
And that is when he said something that struck me as rather odd.
Well, I better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
Chihiro told me he was in a hurry. But why would he be in a hurry? Only if someone were waiting for him, I should think.
So, Mr. Fujisaki was on his way to meet with someone, and then they were going to work out together?
But Hina and I had invited him to exercise with us plenty of times, and he always declined.
Probably because he was afraid you'd find out the secret he was hiding, right?
Which means that conversely, he must have trusted whoever he was meeting with very much, enough so that he was willing to risk his secret being revealed.
Ooh, what a marvelous friendship!
The point is, whoever he met up with is the culprit, right? So we just gotta figure out who it was.
But knowing what we know, I can't even guess.
No. You already have what you need to make the connection.
Huh?
You know who the killer is.
Seriously? Who is it? Who's the killer?
Think back to the track jacket and duffel bag the killer disposed of. Focus on the details of these items, and it should become obvious who was waiting for him.
Are you sure about that? You really think we can figure out who did it based on two pieces of evidence that we don't have?
What? You want to track down some fingerprints or something?
Even if we had the equipment for that, we wouldn't know how to use it.
As was noted, the evidence is already gone. There's nothing to get fingerprints from.
Maybe, but we can make certain inferences if we just take the time to talk it out.
Easy for you to say, but fine. Celeste, did you notice anything special about the bag or jacket?
The bag was just a normal duffel bag from the warehouse. All the bags in there are the same, so I can't imagine what would make that one special.
Well, if I remember right, there was a decent variety of tracksuits to choose from. Do you think there might be some connection between the culprit and Chihiro's jacket?
Perhaps. Let's explore that and talk a bit more about the jacket he took.
Does Chihiro's track jacket really hold some clue about the killer? Somehow, it's really hard to believe.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise. So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
What do you mean, the specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because it matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
I don't even have a tracksuit! Because exercising sucks!
I have a white tracksuit, personally.
I got it from the way.
Did any of that really help us?
No way. Not a chance.
You heard him, right? What he just said was...
Are you saying something off of what someone just said?
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed.
He was on his way, so next week, why did he choose...
What do you mean, this...
I got it! It matched the one the culprit was wearing!
So, what you're saying is... The killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
Shoot!
First of all, we know he was on his way to- So next week, why did he choose-
What do you mean, this-
I got it! It matched the one the culprit was wearing!
But they have two health
bars. So, what you're saying is, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
I don't even have a tracksuit. Cause exercising sucks!
I have a white tracksuit, personally.
I got it from the way-
Did any of that really help us?
No way. Not a chance. You-
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise. So next we have to ask, why did he choose the specific-
What do you mean, the specific-
I got it! It matched the one the culprit was-
So, what-
The killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black!
I don't even- Cause exercising-
I have a white tra- I got it from the way-
Did any of that really help us?
No way. Not a chance. You-
First of all, we know where Chihiro- He was on his way to go exercise.
Oh man, I don't know what I'm doing wrong.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise.
So next week, why did he choose-
What do you mean, this-
I got it! It matched the one-
So, what you're saying is- The killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit-
No, that's wrong!
Hold on a second, Mondo. What did you just say?
Huh? What'd I say?
When Celeste testified a few minutes ago, she said- She never said anything about the jacket's color. So why did you say Chihiro's blue tracksuit?
The way that this was revealed, because like, Mondo slipped here, so this wasn't evidence we gathered. This is like Mondo like accidentally confessing here.
Hey, Celeste, what color was Chihiro's tracksuit?
As a matter of fact, it was blue.
And before we began the trial, did you tell anyone that?
Like, this should have been done during the investigation phase. If they wanted to catch him, that would have been made a better gameplay, like reveal.
The only one and I told the about of the any trial, of this was you. Out.
Then, Mondo, how did you know what color Chihiro's tracksuit was?
It seems like a good place to end it for now. So thanks for watching.